Welkom alweer bij de nieuwe podcastaflevering van de Polygon Seahorse podcast. We hebben vandaag een gast in onze podcast uit Italië. We hebben Roberta van Miguel Hellas Duikcenter in Calabria te gast. Zij gaat ons vertellen vandaag over het duiken in Calabria. Wat is er zo speciaal aan? Wat is er daar te vinden? Welke accommodaties zijn er? Kortom, alles wat we moeten weten over het duiken in Calabria in het zuiden van Italië. Omdat het zuiden van Italië is eigenlijk niet zo'n bekende of toegankelijkere of een populaire duikplaats of duikbestemming voor duikers in België en Nederland. En daar willen we graag verandering in brengen. En daarom graag welkom, Roberta.
Good morning.
Hallo, everything okay with you?
Yes, I'm fine. Nice to be with you here.
Yes, it's a few months that we see each other because I was a few months ago was in Calabria for my assistant instructor course. Roberta, can you introduce yourself?
Oh, yes. Thank you very much, Glenn. Thank you very much to invite me to do this podcast about my beautiful land that I love so much. Calabrian girl, in fact. I was born here. And I manage a diving center in Marina di Gioiosa Ionica, that is in the very southern part of Calabria. I'm a scuba diver instructor, SSI assistant instructor trainer, and XR instructor. But not only, I'm even a tourist guide and an archaeologist. So our diving center is a little bit different because what we do with travelers, not guests, with travelers, is to make them live our region totally. Underwater, inland, the food, the sceneries. Because there's a lot to see in Calabria. And few people knows. So we try to do a lot of work about this, to make people know that in the southern Italy, in the center of Mediterranean Sea, there's a region that offers a lot underwater and even inland.
Okay. I was in Calabria, as I told, and I know the few first days you're always telling me easy, easy, easy. And that's the way that you say you want to help your guests or your travelers to make the lifestyle of Calabria. That's right.
Yes, yes, in fact, perfect. It's not an industry for us. Mm-hmm. For us, it's to welcome people and to make them enjoy moments, time. It's a kind of slow tourism because we are talking about tourism, not only education. Of course, it's possible like you to come to us to attend courses of every level, but it's possible to come for a scuba diving trip with schools or families or friends. And what we try to make them feel is the atmosphere of our land, mm-hmm.
to feel the
sunshine of the on the skin, because we have 300 days of sunshine per year, and to live in a different way, slowly.
Yeah.
So no hurry. We work often with small groups. We don't like 40, 50 people all together, but maximum 20, 25, but the best is 15, 12, 15. And to make them enjoy the places, this is the best. Yeah. To move around our coastline, that is very long, because on the tip of the peninsula, we are like an island with three different seas, Ionian Sea on east, Tyrrhenian Sea on west, that meet each other in the scenery of the Strait of Messina. So using this condition, we can provide diving more or less always, because if there's bad weather on one coastline, we move on the other coastline.
Yeah.
And even the way we move is different, because we have rubber boat in the port of Rocella, but we move a lot by minivan on the road. Mm-hmm. Because Calabria is short, only 40 kilometers on the two coastline. And many dives are from the shore because the sea bottom is very steep, even close to the coastline. So it's possible to reach wrecks or rift from the shore.
Mm-hmm. All right, cool. Roberta, I want to know something more about yourself. So can you tell me when and why did you start diving?
Oh, I started diving when I was 23, but it was a long time after I would like to do. Because I was a kid when I was reading Jules Verne, you know, and I was thinking, oh my God, I would like to go underwater. I want to see what there's under the surface of the sea. It's something hidden in me. And it's something connected with my job of archaeologist, because it's to discover what is underground or under the sea, more or less is the same idea. So I started when I was 22, when it was possible for me and my family. And my education was very fast because I was lucky to live close to the sea. So it was possible for me to attend courses spring, winter time. And then when I met Francesco, that is my partner, we decided to change our life and to open a diving center together that now exists from 17 years. The last year will be the 18th. At the beginning, we were small, only working with local people. Then many people from the northern part of Italy started to come to visit us. And 6 years ago, we started to go at boat in Dusseldorf. And so to promote even for European travelers, our destination. And I thought that was time to improve this. But it was not this way. In 1 year, a lot of people started to come and they were very happy to visit us. And they started to promote by themselves the location. And so now we work with German tourists, Polish, from Belgium, Denmark, from Czech Republic. And our destination is an ideal place because we have a very long good season. From May to November, now it's the middle of October, and outside there are 23 degrees. I'm still this way, and underwater the temperature is from 23, 24 to 18, 19, very deep.
Yeah.
Okay. So my life is strictly connected with diving center. We are open all around here, so we are always working on this. In winter time, often I work still like archaeologist, and it's even an advantage for the diving center because when we move by van, for example, I can tell a lot about underwater archaeology and about what is to visit in the place where we go diving. So it's interesting. So my life is always changing. In the different months, because I work like tourist guide, and it's make my life I don't know how to say always busy, but it's not tiring because I love very much what I do. And changing, you know, make us to make young.
So the name of your diving center is Megal Hellas. Can you tell us more about that name?
Megalelas is a Greek word. Megalelas means Magna Grecia. Magna Grecia in Latin is the name of our area in the past, during the Greek Age. Because the southern Italy, the entire Calabria, a piece of Puglia, from the 8th century BC till the 1st century, were the place where Greeks and Romans lived. And so the name of our land was Megalellas. That means greater than Greece. In fact, we have a lot of archaeological museums and parks in land and underwater. We have a very long history. And after Greeks, the Romans, and then the Byzantines, till the Middle Ages, travelers can know a very long history of this area that is the basis of the European culture.
You have prepared a presentation, so let's talk about diving in Calabria. I'm really curious because I've dived already with you in Calabria, but I think there is a lot of a lot more to see than I have seen a few months ago. So I'm curious. So let's go.
Yes, Glenn, thanks. In fact, it's true. Who come to visit us then decide to come again and again because there are a lot of spots. And I'm very happy to have the possibility to make you see some picture of this and to talk a little bit more. So, Southern Italy, like I told you, in the center of Mediterranean Sea, where there's a mix of history, biodiversity, and fantastic landscapes. We are in the very tip of the Italian peninsula, and I'm showing you the location, Marina di Gioiosa, where there's this red flag on the Ionian coastline, so on east. But like you can see in the picture, all these flags are our diving spots. So wrecks along the Ionian coastline and the reef and wrecks in the Strait of Messina, that is the area between Calabria and Sicily, when Ionian Sea and Tyrrhenian Sea, that is in the northern part on west, meet each other. Along Tyrrhenian Sea, many cliffs and walls that go down directly, sometimes 50, 60 meters underwater. Mm-hmm. You see the picture, it's like a big mountain. The name of the mountain is Aspromonte, that is 2,000 meters high, only 30 kilometers far from the coastline. So this morphological condition creates a very steep bottom sea. And we are this mix of wrecks and reefs. Many wrecks are historical wrecks of the Second World War, and the reefs are very colorful. So now we go to see more about both of these conditions. And we start from the wrecks, because are along the Ionian coastline, where we are located. Ionian Sea is the route of the shipping convoys during the Second World War, from Trieste to Africa. So the very last part of the Italian peninsula where we are was the place where cargo boats, where submarines stopped before going in the open Mediterranean Sea. So after 1943, there were a lot of battles, and the result is that we have a lot of historical wrecks underwater. One of these wrecks is very close to our base, only 8 minutes by rubber boat from the port of Rocella Ionica, is Pasubio wreck. It's an Italian cargo boat, was not armed, but he was in the middle of the battles during the war, and so was shot, and now is on the sandy bottom, 44 meters deep. The upper part is at 35 meters. Is totally intact, 90 meters long. You can enjoy a lot of details. The very big anchors on the two sides of the bow, and the steering wheel in at the end of the wreck is one of the more beautiful part of the wreck. With the propeller, there's the possibility to see the propeller under the stern. It's possible to go inside for the divers that are qualified to do this. And because it's a wreck on the sand, that's even a lot of life around it and inside it, a lot of groupers, because you can imagine that the wreck on the sand became a shelter for fishes. So it's a dive interesting not only for history, but even for biodiversity that you can meet on the wreck. Yeah. So this wreck is for even recreational divers with deep certification. But we have a lot of deep wrecks even for technical divers. Another wreck very close to Pasubio is Fort Missanabie. Fort Missanabie was a cargo English boat, but armed. In this picture, you can see a cannon that is in the upper part at 55 meters. It's a very huge boat broken into pieces. One piece is upside down, like you can see in the map. And it's possible to dive with a deep air till 60 meters or 3 meters because the bottom is 75. It's a so huge wreck that it's impossible with only one diver to see the wreck. Look, for example, the propeller, how big they are. Look at the dive close to the propeller. So yeah. Small, close to the propeller. A lot of fishes around the wreck, even in this case. And the possibility to meet even big fishes. Of course, it's unpredictable, but this is the sea. This is Mediterranean Sea. I would like to remind you that it's open sea. So we don't know what we meet when we go underwater, but it's possible to meet moonfish, for example. Mm-hmm. And two times in 15 years, we meet even sharks.
Yeah. It's nice to see that the photos that you have used in your presentation, they're from Stefan Panis. It's also one of our podcast members. So it's nice to see that that he delivered the photos for your presentations. Nice.
Yes, and he came two times to visit us. It was very nice to meet him. A very good diver, but even a very good photographer. Like you can see these fantastic pictures.
Yes. Absolutely.
And even the San Marin, the Milo San Marin, is another technical dive, very emotional. In this case, divers are not taken by the details of the wreck, are not taken by the biodiversity, by the life, but from the feeling of the Italian soldiers that are still inside the wreck. Mm-hmm. The Milo San Marin, in fact, was one of the four Italian oceanic submarine, built very big, 90 meter long, to go across the ocean sea. And the submarine was very new, was built in 1941, and sunk in 1942, so only 1 year after the building of the wreck. Mm-hmm. Was on the surface when it was shattered by a German U-boat, and sunk on a 70-meter bottom, totally intact. There's only the place of shattering close to the bow, with 55 people that are still inside the wreck. Mm-hmm. So it's like a common grave. Yeah. It's a visit to be done in silence. Yeah. 13 people were saved, one taken by a local fisherman of Monasterace, where the submarine is located 25 minutes far from our base. And everything is perfect, the cannons. You see in the picture the system for the direction of the cannons.
Yeah, yeah.
Every detail is like an emotional detail, because you see the history that really stopped in that terrible day of 1942.
Yeah. It's like they pushed the stop button or the pause button, and then time stopped there at the bottom of the sea.
Yes, yes. It's like a time machine. And always divers, when they finish the dive and arrive to the surface, they are in silence.
Yeah.
And this is probably one of the best technical dive to do in our area because of the feeling that the dives leaves on the the people who visit it.
Yeah.
But we have more wrecks for recreational divers, always along the Ionian Sea, like Kosala wreck, that like Pasubio is from 35 till 45 meter on the sandy bottom. This is even an Italian cargo boat, but in this case, there's the cannon in the open space of the stern. And the wreck is full of details, like the two anchors, like the chains, the system to collect the chains. So it's possible to plan, for example, a tour of the wrecks visiting us to all the places along the Ionian coast and the Strait of Messina, where there are historical wrecks. Many of them are for deep divers or technical divers, but not only. This is even for deep divers. And imagine, this is from the shore.
Okay.
34, no. 45 meters from the shore, only 4 minutes swimming. And then down this German cargo barge in the southern part of our coastline. Mm-hmm. This is a wreck that usually photographers love a lot because the wreck is not so big. It's only 15 meters long and 5 meters large. So with a wide angle, it's possible to see the entire wreck when visibility is good. And so photographers always ask to go on this wreck from the shore. But like I told you, we have not only deep wrecks, but even for open water, for example. We have two wrecks in very shallow water, 10, 12 meters. This, like this Italian cargo boat that is called Capitan Antonio. And even if it's not totally intact, like the historical wrecks, because you can imagine where there's shallow water, the waves during the winter time destroy a little bit them year by year. Yeah. Mm-hmm. In any case, became shelter for fishes, and there are many spaces intact, like a part of the bow, like the kitchen, like a little piece of the stern. And because it's in shallow water, it's possible to see it even for snorkeling, for snorkelers. So it's nice if there are companions not diving, they can share the visit with us, looking the wreck from the surface. Another one, even in shallow water, the Kingtown wreck, 4 meters the upper part, 9 meters the bottom. Perfect even in this case for photographers because there's a lot of light. And it's possible to see the wreck surrounded by fishes and even in this case for snorkelers. So Calabria, advanced of be surrounded by two seas. Till now we went like a trip along the Ionian coast going south and arriving at the beginning of the Strait of Messina. Strait of Messina is a very unique scenery, something nothing to compare in Mediterranean Sea, because the meeting of the two seas create currents. Currents that could be very strong and that we have to avoid. In fact, we have tide tables to know the correct timing for the dive. But underwater, the dive is amazing because this current, because of the food that there's in the water, create a very huge biodiversity and very clear crystal water. Visibility is always very good. Often from 40 meters, you can see the surface. So that what the divers can see in the province of Reggio Calabria, where we are, is a huge variety of different diving spots. And even in the Strait of Messina, there are wrecks that in this case are full of colors because of the currents. Look at the iron of the wreck, totally covered with Leptosamia pruvoti, this kind of small coral yellow. In fact, this wreck, Alva, is even called the wreck in yellow because it's covered with these yellow corals. It's upside down. So it's a dive like in the belly of a whale. And the upper part is 26 meters, and the propeller from the sand are 54 meters. So you see again, from advanced, deep, till technical divers, even in this case, from the shore. So it's amazing that you can reach this depth doing a jump from the shore on the sandy bottom. And in the Strait of Messina, there's even one of the most beautiful huge shipwrecks of the Second World War on the Mediterranean Sea, that is the Val Fiorita. Val Fiorita is known even like the Tisle Gorm of Mediterranean Sea, because it's all full with equipment of the Italian army of the Second World War. You can see cars inside, you can see bombs, you can see weapons, and totally intact, only the bow is broken and leaning on the left-hand side of the wreck, and totally covered by colorful sponges and corals. Mm-hmm. The stern from 50 to 70 meters is covered with black corals. And even in this case, it's a technical dive, but you can start to dive even with a deep air. It's something huge. Look at the cars inside. Look at the motorcycles.
Yeah.
So many details that when you ask one time, when you dive once of this wreck, you decide to dive again and again.
It's like the Tisle Gorm, as you said.
Yes, yeah. Yes, it's only deeper.
Yeah.
It's deeper, but for this reason, it's probably more intact than Tisle Gorm.
Yeah.
But like I told you, the Strait of Messina is a mix of fantastic biodiversity with a very crystal water. Look at Scilla. Scilla is considered one of the 10 most beautiful diving spots of Italy. And it's very nice, not only underwater, but even outside, with the Ruffo Castle on the rock and the Chianalea, that is the fisherman village, with the houses built directly into the sea, like a little Venice. In Scilla, diving from the shore, you see this picture. This is our minivan. That is parked along the promenade. We prepare the equipment very comfortable here, and then few steps into the water. 3 minutes of navigation and you are this underwater. Mm-hmm. Very huge red and yellow gorgonians. And because of the light that there's underwater, you can see the yellow color even without lamps. Is something fantastic. You feel like in a garden, a big garden surrounded by fishes, and you spend times the only looking around you. You don't decide to swim, but to admire the place you have around you, with the possibility to meet special fishes, for example, the trumpet fish. The trumpet fish are deep fishes. Usually they live 1,000 meters, 1,200 meters deep. Only in the Strait of Messina it's possible to see them in Mediterranean Sea because of the currents. They arrive in shallow water close to the coastline in 5-10 meters. So it's possible to meet them. And night dives in this place are very, very nice because of the biodiversity you can meet. Mm-hmm. And the black coral is another important feature of the Strait of Messina. There are many reefs close to Scilla where it's possible to see like a mountain with snow, if I have to think something to compare, because of the white color of the black coral that covers this reef. It's a deep dive from 60 meters and deep for technical divers that you can see in the picture. Mm-hmm. But you can imagine the advance for technical divers to come in Calabria and to see not only wrecks, but even a unique biodiversity on two different coastlines. Mm-hmm. And from Scilla, if we continue to go north, we start to enter in the Tyrrhenian Sea. Tyrrhenian Sea along the coastline where the mountain arrives very vertical on the sea with cliffs. The name of this piece of coastline is Violet Coast because of the colors that the sea and the mountains have during the sunset. Pink, red, purple, violet. There are, I think, 20, 25, 30 different diving spots in this place. Cliffs, caves, reefs, you have only to choose. Yep. And a lot of canyons from 5 meters, so even in shallow water, like the picture on the left, this picture is taken in 5 meters, till 60 meters, like again, the black coral surrounded by red gorgonias that you can see in these walls vertical till 65 meters. Along Violet Coast, the gorgonias are not too colored like in Scilla, are only red, but are huge again. And it's possible to meet a lot of fishes around us. And even for open water, like the picture on the right, it's possible to have fantastic scenery with colorful sponges, very good visibility, and a lot of fishes around us. But the surprises are not finished, because in Marina di Gioiosa, now we are back at the base, so we have circumnavigated Aspromonte, the mountain, along Ionian Sea, Stretto of Messina, Tyrrhenian Sea, and then we are back in Gioiosa, where a colony of seahorses always live on our sandy bottom. Marina di Gioiosa, in fact, has a coastline with pebbles that goes down slowly till 12 meters and then became very steep from 12 meters till 400 meters. It's like a hole in front of our base, and from this depth, especially during the night, a lot of little shrimps come to the surface that are what seahorses love, what seahorses eat. And in Marina di Gioiosa, we have both species present in Italy. Hippocampus hippocampus, that is a species under risk, and Hippocampus gutulatus. We can see them in every dive, 98%. We see them different colors. We see them pregnant with the belly. This July, I had the possibility, the lucky moment, to see one of them that gave to light the very little seahorses. What so an emotion to see something like this, mm-hmm, in nature, not, created by people, but underwater in the natural habitat. Mm-hmm. So we see even very baby seahorses very often. So for photographers, for sea life lovers, for biologists, this is highlights, of course, because we are sure to see seahorses underwater.
No. And I can agree that.
And at the end of what I consider very important to tell about my land is history. Because we are the heart of Magna Grecia, of Megalellas. And yes, we have a lot of museums and archaeological parks to visit in land, but even underwater. And for everybody, because these Greek columns that you see in the picture on the right are at only 6 meters. So with open water, even with dry scuba, it's possible to see them. Yeah. And of course, doing snorkeling. This is a unique place in Italy when the coastline in the past was 300 meters far from the modern coastline. And now there are the ruins of the Greek temple of the 5th century BC very close to the beach. And in front of the ruins of the temple underwater, there are 200 pieces of Greek columns and architectural elements. It's a very emotional visit, even in this case, because it's amazing to see that what we what is underwater now was inland 2,500 years ago. And this is still intact like a time machine.
Yeah.
Of course, there's a biodiversity around the columns. So we can see nudibranch with the eggs, we can see jellyfish, we can see sponges and fishes hidden are under the columns. Everywhere we dive in Calabria is not only historical place of a scenery, interesting place, but is always full of biodiversity. Yeah. And from recreational diving to technical diving, it's a place for everybody, I have to confess. And our base, that is in front on the promenade of Marina di Gioiosa in front of the beach, is equipped to host recreational divers and technical divers. We can provide oxygen, helium. We have twins stages, aluminium stages to rent. And we provide services for rebreather divers. So this is our base. You know the place? And
yeah, I know the place.
We have two compressors. We use one only for helium and oxygen, and another one for air for bottles. So we have 12, 15, or 18 liters bottles, so for every request. And this is our base inside the reception. The space is like are now after COVID. We hope we are after COVID.
Yeah.
With the equipment to rent, the classroom for students, the laundry to leave the equipment to dry after diving. We provide boxes to the divers so they can leave their equipment with their name of the time they stay at our base. And this is our rubber boat. 7.5 meter long, that is in the port of Rocella Ionica. And these are our minivan that we use to move from the dives from the shore along the Ionian and Tyrrhenian coastline. The maximum distance we do by van is 1 hour. And when we drive 1 hour, then we stay on the spot and we do a full day. We dive twice, for example, in Scilla or along Violet Coast.
Yeah.
But not only diving. If you plan a tour in southern Italy with us, we organize a trip like if you go, you know, in Red Sea, in other country, when you decide to visit even the place where you are. So very ancient churches of the Byzantine or Roman age. A lot of waterfalls immersed in the nature, a fantastic national park that is Aspromonte, with medieval towns where the time seems to have stopped in the Middle Ages. So we can organize for the companions not divers or for the divers for the no-fly day, for example, guided tours, excursion, hiking. There are very different sceneries, even outside, not only underwater. Usually people cannot imagine that Calabria is so green, even in autumn, for example, or so colorful in springtime. And the landscapes are breathtaking, even because the mountain high is so close to the coastline. So you can enjoy very wide landscapes from the hills, and everywhere unforgettable food and wine, very genuine food, and even very cheap. You can eat very good food more or less when you stop. The restaurants are 0 kilometers in many cases. The quality of the food is more or less everywhere good, in many places excellent. Yeah. And we can organize dinners for the divers. So what I hope is to see you in Calabria again with us or with other divers.
Yes, of course. Thank you very much, Roberta, for your presentation. I've seen a lot of things that I can recognize from my last trip to Calabria. I have to plan another trip to Calabria because I have a lot of things to see. So maybe I have to plan another trip. So how can people get in touch with you to come diving with in Calabria and with Miguel Helas?
By mail, by phone. Our diving center website is in Italian, in English, in French, and in German. And there's the contact form to reach us. So there's my email, by phone, even by WhatsApp. Yeah. So it's possible to contact me. And then I provide all the information about the location, about the accommodation, in case I can help about the accommodation, because we have some agreements with hotel or with bed and breakfast. We can provide the shuttle service to the airport. The airport is La Mezzia Terme and is very well furnished with flights from many cities of the central part of Europe. From many airports, it's possible to have a connection from March to November direct, or in any cases, changing in Rome or Milan.
Yeah.
And if booked months before, it's even very cheap. It's not expensive flight because there are many low-cost flights that fly on La Mezzia Terme.
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. I have a last question. What are your plans for the next few months and years with Miguel Helas?
Oh, we are thinking, first of all, to be back again at boat in Düsseldorf, to start again after COVID time with, normal life, we hope. And we are planning to do some special activities, like in July, an archaeological summer field, 1 week about underwater archaeology, with training, what to do in case of discovery, how to dig underwater, how to inform a local superintendents. So activities connect with history, because I'm an archaeologist and working with superintendents, I can teach what to do in case. And then wrecks, looking for new wrecks. We are always looking, we use the winter time, to check spots that the fishermen told us that could be interesting to see, often deep, but rebreeders and technical divers are always more in Europe and all around the world, ready to visit new wrecks.
Yeah. You have a boat. How many divers with rebreeders, for example, can you
on the rubber boat? Actually, on the rubber boat, the best is six.
Six.
Considering rebreeder, three stages, scooter.
Yeah.
Okay. If we talk about rebreeder and one stage, it could be even eight. Mm-hmm. So it depends on the configuration.
Yeah,
we can manage to have another rubber boat in case, but our philosophy is to work with not big groups, especially with technical divers, to enjoy the place. It's not nice to be 10 or 12. We provide the wrecks with a line, with a rope to go down. And we organize the safety stop under the rubber boat, and usually for 6-8 technical divers maximum.
Mm-hmm. All right. Perfect. Thank you very much, Roberta. maybe we can see each other on both next year in, I think, January, I think it is.
Yes, the last 10 days of January, yes.
Yeah, all right. Okay, thank you very much for your time and your wonderful explanation and presentation about diving in Calabria. Hopefully we can make a lot of divers enthusiast about diving in Calabria so they can contact you for their diving vacation next year or maybe in December already. I have to thank my listeners. So bedankt luisteraars voor het luisteren en het kijken. Heb je vragen over deze aflevering, kan je mailen naar polygonseahorse.be, sorry, dus de podcast at thepolygonseahorse.be, of stel ze via onze social media. We zijn te vinden op Facebook en Instagram, dus stel je gerust daar al de vragen over het duiken in Calabria. Ik zorg dan wel dat de vragen bij Roberta terechtkomen. Wil je ons steunen, dan kan je ons promoten en onze aflevering ook delen op jullie eigen sociale media. Kijk zeker eens op onze website voor onze merchandising, want met die opbrengst kunnen we eigenlijk onze podcast blijven maken. Ik was Glenn de Wilde en ja, we horen en zien elkaar bij de volgende aflevering. Bye bye.